some mentioning about the present scenario of the country. Yes, you are backing, I should say, the well-constructed theory which suggested that capitalization, how it is controlling our whole society. I am from the very rural background of Karnataka. I can say that how the yellow buses entering the villages, they are not just destroying the very colour schools, but also the cultures which is there in the families. That completely the structure has been changing. The changing structure may be like you know, we are using coconut, we are using soya bean because some American company says that coconut oil is so much cholesterol or so much called, you know, this kind of thing. First point I mentioned, yes, how today's government is tackling the effort. And secondly, when we see, yes, there are some states like Tamil Nadu, which have tried and which have succeeded in bringing in the whole technical education and medical education in the better country. Why such kind of initiations are not taken by other states also?
You see, the first unit of my lecture is addressed to our literary writers. In the soon after we got independence, leftist, economic leftist, that means Marxism, distribution of wealth, became the dominant theme of our literary writers. But gradually we realized, that means that this state-controlled economy and suppressing the individual enterprise has pushed our country into utter poverty, and it became inevitable for us to become a country of free enterprise. Now, even after we have witnessed the inevitability of free enterprise, our intellectuals and our literary writers have not reconciled themselves to the philosophy of free enterprise. Our literary writers have not reconciled. This is all the point I am pointing out. I am not going into other details of economics because I am not a professor of economics and this is not a thesis of economics.
I have one question.
One question.
Education should be imparted in mother tongue till high school level. Fine. Now question is, if the parents of that children is in government office and is transferred from his own state to another state, now the children will face the problem because India, a multilingual country like India, has different languages in different states. Then how do they cope up with that? Next one, just now I came to know from the previous speaker that the Tamil Nadu government has introduced engineering curriculum in mother tongue. Now, in that way, we will be confined to that only Tamil Nadu and the speaker of other languages, other states won't be able to get entrance there because they don't know Tamil. So, how will
we... You are speaking of the problem of transferable central government officials. What is the percentage of such people? And what is the percentage of the other people? Now, the solution to the problem of the transferable central government servants, you are imposing on the rest of the population.
Yeah.
Aren't you?
They are minority, but of course they are less in number. And but how will their problem be solved?
No. The problem is, see, for this only central government has started central schools and send your children to central schools. But what is the population, what is the percentage of the people? Now you see what happened is, first the problem started, the transferable central government. I worked in a college called Regional College of Education, which is a constituent of NCERT. And Regional College of Education has a school called Demonstration Schools, where educational experimentation is to take place. That is up to high school. Now, in demonstration schools, the medium of instruction became English, because English is considered to be the all India language. Now, who should be the students for that? The government decided the children of transferable central government servants should be admitted. Now, they were admitted. But then, those who are working in the regional college, employees who were not transferable also demanded, let our children also be admitted. They were admitted. And then class 4 servants also said, when the children of the professors and readers and lecturers are admitted, why not our children? They went on strike. They also were admitted. So this way, and some influential citizens said, they brought their influence, political influence, their children also to got the admission. Now this way, private colleges, private schools said, we will follow your syllabus only, central syllabus only, give us permission. Permission was given because of political influence also. This way is went on multiplied. Now, where do you stop? Where do you stop? That means the pattern, the model becomes the model which was built for the benefit of the transferable central government servants. Suppose you are working in Delhi, you are a central government servant. Theoretically you are transferable, but most probably you will not be transferred. Therefore, you are a Delhiite. Send your children to the school where the local language is Hindi. Admit it. And also you demand that your child be taught your mother tongue, either Kannada, Tamil or Telugu, as a language. But medium of instruction here should be Hindi. And same should be applied in other states also. There are many central government officials and central government institutions in various other states also. And their children, they always maintain, psychologically that they don't belong to that state. They work there, they get the site, they get the house under the state quota because they are staying there. But they don't allow their children to study in the local language. This mentality of the central government officers' mentality has very much influenced our medium of instruction policy.
Learn Gita, this word of Gita. I have seen Bhagavad Gita to Gita. For only I am the only person in the world to my best, the best of my knowledge and belief who sees Bhagavad Gita to Gita. Which happens like a ladder. And what is that? How can we bring back the glory of Sanskrit today?
No, no, no. My purpose is not to bring back the glory of Sanskrit. I have made it very clear. In the elementary knowledge of Sanskrit is necessary for the growth of our languages. I am not speaking of mere Kannada. For a person to know good Hindi, knowledge of Sanskrit is necessary. For a person to know good Bengali, elementary knowledge of Sanskrit is necessary. To know Marathi, to know Gujarati, to know Punjabi. Whatever the languages, elementary, I am only saying that at least up to high school, elementary knowledge of Sanskrit is necessary. And from Christian point of view, what happens is, if you have elementary knowledge of Sanskrit and later on you want to do some research in history, you can develop that elementary knowledge easily and then go to original historical sources in Sanskrit. You want to do research in sociology, you can develop it and go to original sources in Sanskrit. You want to do research in anything and you want to write some science books in your mother tongue, that elementary level will help you. That is why I am only saying elementary Sanskrit should be taught. What happens is, when a child is young, to know the elementary language, terminology, Amarakosha, and then Karaka especially, it should be by heart. And when you grow up, you don't have the patience, and it becomes very difficult for you to know the elementary structure of Sanskrit. Therefore, why don't you teach it when a child is very capable of knowing it? That is all I am saying, because it helps our education. And to become a literary writer, if you don't have elementary knowledge of Sanskrit, you cannot read our ancient Indian languages. Not only that, you cannot develop your own language. You cannot knowledge of Sanskrit gives precision and depth and clarity to our language. Whatever the language, it may be Kannada, it may be Bengali, or whatever the language. That's all I am pleading for. I am not saying Sanskrit should dominate, etc. No.
Actually, the observations that you have made and the anxieties that you have expressed are known anxieties. In fact, these anxieties have been expressed by many thinkers, scholars since a long time. But my point is, I think there is another dimension to the whole debate. In a country like India, English is also a means of liberation. Remember, I would have been carrying cow dung on my head. I think when we talk about because I also come from the same state. That's why I wanted to bring in Guwahati here. English is also a means of liberation in India. It's one. So that's why we should discuss the hegemony of English at a different level altogether. That's one. Secondly, in your lecture, you lamented about the disconnect with Sanskrit. For me, the real problem is not the disconnect with Sanskrit, the disconnect with our own Indian languages. See, as a teacher, as a scholar of as a teacher, as a reader of literature, I don't know who is a great writer in Tamil, who is a great writer in Telugu. See, there should be a greater interaction between Indian languages. The emphasis should be on this.
I never said the interaction between one Indian language and another Indian language should be stopped. I never said it. I want more and more interaction. I want more and more integration. But when you mentioned in Sanskrit, Kuvempu, I tell you, Kuvempu had studied Sanskrit to a great extent. His knowledge of Sanskrit was really great. He had read English also. When he was the Vice Chancellor of Mysore University, it was he who said Kannada should be the medium of instruction up to MA and MSc, and English should remain the library language. There is a distinction. English should become the library language and all the knowledge should come to Kannada. Therefore, we must translate all best works in all the subjects in the world into Kannada through translation. That's how we can develop our language. It doesn't everyone can read English. Everyone should read in the original English. This translation work should continue in all the languages.
Sir, may I just be permitted? Sorry, I am coming up again. on two issues, sir. Once you talked about English. English may have a wonderful dimension. It may be a language of liberation. But there has to be some balance between your culture and the liberation. You want to reach out to the world, your global world. But what is the strength from where you are coming? The strength is the Indian strength, your cultural strength. You need strength to reach out to jump higher in life. So you cannot ignore your basic culture to get away from liberation. Japanese are also liberated in the world, but they treasure their heritage. They don't break. That's very important. So managing a good balance is very important, which is lacking in India. Now, connecting it to aspects of Sanskrit.
Why I am saying elementary Sanskrit should be taught is, since the majority of you are Hindi people, I give example in Hindi. You take most of the Hindi words and trace it, the root of that word, it is Sanskrit. How you take any word, the root is Sanskrit. And if you know the root, you can write better Hindi. In the same way, if you know elementary knowledge, I can write better Kannada. And one can write better Bengali. That is why I am reading for elementary knowledge of Sanskrit. It should be started at the personal level. That is all the point. And don't bring in any sociology. Sanskrit was the language of exploitation. It was the language of upper caste. Don't bring caste, community, etc. It is uncalled for and it is dangerous and destructive to our country.
Professor Bhairappa ji has raised, even a whole day we can discuss on this topic, is how this, the points he has raised. Friends, as I mentioned, the lecture what he has delivered today is going to be released, and thereafter you can have a copy of it. You can collect a copy from the outside counter and go through it, and whatever possible you can implement in your whatever he suggested. To get our children in our own language, mother tongues, protecting and all. I request President Sahith Academy to come on the dais and release the book and hand over the copies to Professor Bhairappa ji. And tomorrow's program, in the same place, we have a Purvakri, that is the Northeast and Northern Writers Meet, that is at 10:30. And we have a seminar on regional and national. President's reaction to this lecture, so I request President to say a few words and conclude the कि
मैं भी इसके बारे में कुछ कहूँ। मैं भैरप्पा जी के वक्तव्य से पूरी तरह सहमत हूँ। और उनका यह कहना सही है कि मातृभाषाओं में प्रारंभिक शिक्षा, हम नहीं कहते हायर एजुकेशन दीजिए, प्रारंभिक स्तर पर मातृभाषाओं में शिक्षा देना हमारे बच्चों की मौलिकता को आगे ले जाना है, इसमें कोई संदेह नहीं। दुनिया भर के भाषा वैज्ञानिक और भाषा चिंतक यही बात करते रहे। गुरुदेव रवींद्रनाथ ने बांग्ला में ही कविताएं पहले लिखी क्योंकि उसी में लिख सकते थे। बाद में उसका जब अंग्रेजी हुआ और सी एफ एंड्रयूज और हवाई भी ईव्स वगैरह के हाथों से होके वो गुजरा और नोबल पुरस्कार उसको मिला। तो आपको याद होगा ईव्स ने अपने लेटर्स में सम लेटर्स टू ईव्स एक नर्तकी से प्यार करते थे और उन्होंने उसको कुछ लेटर्स लिखे हैं। उन लेटर्स में एक जगह उन्होंने लिखा है कि रवीन्द्रनाथ को अच्छी अंग्रेजी नहीं आती। आप सोचिए कि रवीन्द्रनाथ टैगोर को अगर अच्छी अंग्रेजी नहीं आती है तो हम लोगों को क्या है। इसलिए जो आपने ये कहा कि इंडियन इंग्लिश राइटर्स हमेशा कोयम दर्जे के नागरिक माने जाएंगे, ये बात भी अपनी जगह पर सही है। और जहां तक संस्कृत का सवाल है, आपने बहुत साफ कर दिया कि संस्कृत में सोशियोलॉजी और ये सब लाने की जरूरत नहीं है। हम संस्कृत टेक्स्ट को स्वीकार करने के लिए नहीं कर रहे हैं कि आप संस्कृत टेक्स्ट का पीछा करिए। आप संस्कृत लैंग्वेज इसलिए पढ़िए कि वो रूट्स तक जाएंगे। हम लोग हिंदी के पाठक हैं, अनेक ऐसे शब्द आते हैं जिन शब्दों पर हम लोगों को चिंता हो जाती है कि इसका रूट क्या है। अगर आपको संस्कृत रूट के वो शब्द पकड़ में आएंगे तो निश्चित रूप से आप सही प्रयोग करेंगे और उसके अर्थ तक पहुंचेंगे और उसको पल्लवित करेंगे। इसलिए मैं ज्यादा मुझे व्याख्यान नहीं देना है, मगर जो कुछ भी आज भैरप्पा जी ने कहा बड़े साहस के साथ, जो सब लोग महसूस करते हैं उस बात को इन्होंने सामने रख दिया। एक जिसको हम कहते हैं कि संस्कृत के आते ही कि ये पावर की लैंग्वेज है और ये डोमिनेटिंग लैंग्वेज रही है, और फिर उसके बाद सोशियोलॉजी और इकोनॉमिक्स के सवाल उठाते हैं, वही हालत को अंग्रेजी के साथ है। अंग्रेजी क्या पावर की लैंग्वेज नहीं है? अंग्रेजी क्या हमारे ऊपर थोपी नहीं जा रही है? हमारा सारा चिंतन क्या अंग्रेजी के वातावरण में नहीं बनाया जा रहा है? संस्कृत के 100 गुना इस समय हम अंग्रेजी के कब्जे में, इससे हमको मुक्त होना चाहिए। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, और भैरप्पा जी को खास तौर से कि उन्होंने बड़े साहस के साथ हमको आगे खड़े होने के लिए एक थॉट प्रोवोकिंग सामग्री दी। बहुत बहुत
ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ನೊಳಗೆ ಇದು ತೀರ್ಮಾನವಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆಯಾ ರಾಜ್ಯದೊಳಗೆ ಆಯಾ राज्य भाषीय शिक्षण माध्यम आगे हईस्कूल मुगद तनकलू अंत पार्लमेंट पास आगे पड़ी
सर इतर बे सरकार अवेरने बेरे स्टेट अवेरने कड़मे
बेरे स्टेट
अवेरने कड़मे
बेरे स्टेट समस्या इशु तीव्रवा याके अंतर्रे नमल्ली शिक्षण माध्यम शाले अंत दुड बिजनेस आगे नमल इंग्लिश मीडियम शाले तकबूद इंजीनियरी आगे मेडिकल दुड बिजनेस मनी मेकिंग बिजनेस आगे बिटिद्रे इंग्लिश माध्यम हल्के नोड़ सिटी मतलब इंग्लिश ओदबिटो अस्टू दिन याके इंग्लिश मीडियम सेरसी अंत इवर मार्केटिंग हे हेकोबारो इलाके आता बेरे कड़ी शिक्षण माध्यम वो उद्यम बिजनेस आगे अदे व्यत्यास
भाषे सायव पैस्थित
बे भाषे साहित्य निम्द कन्ड न्यूज कन्ड वृत्तपत्र ಈಗ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು 25 ವರ್ಷ ಕಳೆಯಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ನಡ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆ ಓದೋರು ಇದಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಹಂಗಾಗೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು 25 ವರ್ಷ ಕನ್ನಡ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆ ಓದೋರು ಇದಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋ ಹಂಗಾಗೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಅವಾಗ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಕನ್ನಡ ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತಾ ಈಗೇನೋ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟೇನೋ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಬೂಮ್ ಇದೆ ಏನೋ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳು ಖರ್ಚಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇದು ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ನಡ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆಗಳು ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಮುಂದುವರಿ ಇದೇ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮ ಹೀಗೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಯಾರು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ನಡ ಟಿವಿ ನೋಡೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಸಂವಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ತಿದ್ದುಪಡಿ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು
ಅದನ್ನ ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ತಿದ್ದುಪಡಿ ಏನು ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಲೈನು ಅಷ್ಟೇನೆ ಇದಾಗೋ ತನಕ ಮಾತೃಭಾಷೆ ರಾಜ್ಯ ಭಾಷೆ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮವಾಗಬೇಕು ಕೊನೆ ಪಕ್ಷ ಹೈಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಮುಗಿಯೋ ತನಕ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ತಿದ್ದುಪಡಿ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಸ್ವರ್ಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ
ಸರ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬಹಳ ಉಚಿತವಾದ ಒಂದು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯವರಿಗೆ
ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಸಮ್ಮ
ನಂತರ ಇದರಿಂದ ಏನೋ ಅದು ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಆ ಅರ್ಹತೆ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಹಂಗಿದ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಇದರಿಂದಾಗಿ ಬೇರೆಪ್ಪನವರಿಗೆ ಅವಮಾನ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ
ನೋಡಿ ಈ ವಿಷಯದೊಳಗೆ ನನಗೆ ರಾಜಕೀಯದೊಳಗೂ ಆಸಕ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯದ ರಾಜಕೀಯದೊಳಗೂ ಆಸಕ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಎಳೆಯದಾಗಿದೆ
ಇದು ನೀವು ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯದ ರಾಜಕೀಯ
ನನಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಚರ್ಚೆನೂ ನನಗೆ ಆಸಕ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಈ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಯೇ ಬೇಡ
कल हिंदू में आ सकता है कुछ कंट्रोवर्शियल डाल के हिंदू कुछ कंट्रोवर्शियल
हिंदू में कुछ आ जाता है हिंदू
थोड़ा से लिखा के निकाल के वो भी वर्ड्स इन डिफरेंट जॉनर्स अदरवाइज एवरीबॉडी विल स्पीक सेम थिंग यू कैन अलॉट नो सोइंग सो पर्सन विल टॉक दिस पर्टिकुलर जॉनर फ्रॉम पर्सन विल टॉक प्लीज कॉल इट दैट इज द संवाद आफ्टर प्रेजेंटेशन दिस इज आवर कन्वेंशन that questions and all will arrange in Mysore in a hall where the our president and vice president will be there they will be in the fellow clerk and all after that there will be a this kind of presentations will be there we will talk about your works a kind of critical evaluation
because the audience also will be Kannada only if it is in Mysore. Only president will not understand, but we will tell him.
just for one person, why should you all will suffer?
वो कन्नडा में आप बोलिए यू स्पीक इन कन्नडा
आनंद
चावड़ा गुजराती राइटर Orator, he started speaking about Gujarati literature. I almost completely understood.
Understood. Yes, that is Sanskrit root. That is Sanskrit root.
And I believe Hindi becomes Buddhism. It is
Sanskrit Bhagavad. Yes.
Another Sanskrit. It is India.
The Nawab Bhave publicly told that he told, I learned so many languages, but Hindi is the easiest one.
So your first book is translated in Hindi. Make Sanskrit, make Hindi acceptable to all the Indians in order to make it, bring it nearer Sanskrit.
Yes.
मोहन भागवत से. Let's take the word and then have it.